difference.
Yeah.
Difference how? The way it smells, the way it looks.
The flavor, just the
I can
the
definitely smell the
aroma.
Flavor a lot more. It's a lot more pronounced.
Yeah, quite a bit. It's definitely almost in the door right now.
Yeah, a little bit.
Cameroon.
Yeah.
Really? Yeah, more of a sweet smell to it.
That's like... real sweet smell to cut it. How's that? Oh yeah, bring it back to there. What the hell is it?
What do you think about the way it looks?
It looks rough.
It's veiny.
Looks real rough.
Yeah. Real hard.
I got a few patches in mine. I like the smell.
I can't remember.
I guess there's some patches.
You got some patches in yours, though?
A couple. Not a lot, but...
I got a big one and a small one.
You smell the end of it. Together. Very distinct.
Smells nutty.
Real earthy.
Sweet to me.
It's not near as sweet either.
Oh yeah.
It smells more like fresh cut tobacco. That's what it actually smells like. Right when they're taking the plants down. It's kind of like fresh cut hay. You get that real sweet, real earth kind of smell to it.
When you open it up and take a puff on it before you light it, have any distinct flavors?
Man, that's a real light draw. I'm surprised for as hard as that is. Like a woody taste. I like those smells already.
It's definitely more taste.
It definitely smells a lot nicer.
Smoother taste. Yeah, I like this taste.
What are your first impressions so far now that you got it lit?
I think there's a blend. I'm still tasting woody, sweet, nutty.
Creamy would be a good one.
If you had to guess, where do you think the cigar's going to go? Do you think it's going to get a lot stronger? Do you think it's going to stay consistent? Just judging by those first few puffs.
I don't know about stronger, but definitely probably going to get tastier. Definitely going to change.
Yeah.
He's definitely got his own character already now.
I think the first cigar was like eating, the only analogy, like putting Vidalia onions on something, on a salad. This one with the first couple of puffs is like when you saute the onions. I mean, you have a much more complex taste and aroma and feel.
It's got a nice aftertaste. Yeah, definitely.
It's almost appetizing.
Yeah.
Very friendly.
vein, nothing's happening as I'm smoking it down.
What do you think of the body, the texture of the smoke?
Friendly. Inviting.
It's not harsh. This is the beginning. It's light, but it's not flavorless.
What do you think of the volume of smoke?
It's a little more volume, but not overpowering.
What do you think of the draw? Easy to get smoke through the cigar?
Oh, yeah.
Pretty light draw. But a lot lighter.
Mine's a tighter draw than the first one. Not a lot of flavor, but a nicer aroma on the nose.
Yeah, it almost has a floral. That's a good one.
What do you think about the level of nicotine so far?
This one seems a lot lighter than the last one.
The last one, I was creeped up on you. It's a little more pronounced than it was in the first third of the other one. So I'm guessing it probably is going to stay a little more consistent throughout.
Get more of a leather taste to it. That's almost what it smells like too. Like, you go into a tack shop with some good fresh leather, you get that kind of sweet earthy taste smell going on. Have you ever walked into a tack shop? You're cutting leather? Got that real friendly kind of smell, kind of horse, a little bit of horsey, a little bit of leather. Some of that horse shit laying around.
What do you think, by the way, it's burning?
It's burning pretty evenly.
It's got a good burn line. It's a little thicker.
Okay. What do you think of the ash?
It's a lot lighter than the last one.
It's got more flavor though. There's something, it's changing already. You taste it.
My ash is kind of dark and it's a little on the rough side.
Mine's real light.
Mine's light.
Mine's real light.
It's very smooth. There's nicotine in this one. But the flavors are. I even taste a little cocoa.
Yeah, it's definitely sweeter. Yeah.
I guess you can't always go by the wrapper.
Well, it seems like that's all you can go by, because I would probably put a safe bet to it that it's probably the same manufacturer. And if they did change it, they didn't change it that much. I would have to say no, you can't always go by the wrapper.
Because if this is the same cigar with the Camelot wrapper, the darker wrapper, it's amazing what a wrapper can do, but...
Yeah, it ain't just the wrapper. There's flavors coming from more than just the wrapper. You can taste it.
Well, that cigar you had last time was... That's not very common to have binder and filler all the same. Typically when a cigar is blended, it's blended to go with the wrapper. You know, they don't want to just slap something on the cigar. It might not taste right. The case in point being the Oliva Serie V. When that cigar was originally released, they were going to do a Maduro version as well. When they put that Maduro wrapper on that blend, it didn't work, so they didn't produce it. They're working on it, but it never hit the market. They've re-blended that cigar for the Maduro wrapper, and it's supposed to come out October 15th. So they may taste similar, but the blend is not the same.
It's got a lot more like a fruity flavor to it. There's like a lot of light. It's not really sweet, but it's not, you know, specific. But it's inviting. makes you want to keep smoking it.
It's like a Spanish girl. A little exotic. You know it's going to warm up well.
You're learning.
When we say sweet, what do you mean? Like sugary sweet? Like
no, that's why sweet, I said fruit.
Sweetener?
It's like, it's sweet, but it's not a real strong sweet. It's a real light sweet. Not light like a creamy taste. It's definite specific. It's like with a lot of fruits, when you eat them, you have that sweet aftertaste, but it's not a sugary sweet. It's something that's nice that you don't mind, you know? You're going to taste that for a while, and it's a good thing.
I don't eat fruits.
What do you think about the construction of the cigar? Feel solid? Feel fragile? Weak?
Not weak. Mine is nice and solid.
Yeah, I think it's pretty solid.
Mine's good. Really, really mushy. That's the way my first one was.
Yeah, this one's getting real soft.
Softening up, but it's not. Soft, not like the first one.
Then right in the middle of my cigar, it's like really soft, spongy.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Do you like the heat's loosening it up?
I don't think there's as much smoke off of this cigar either.
No, I think the last cigar produced a lot of smoke.
Yeah.
Resting smoke is almost none.
It had a light, rich smoke on the last one. This one just...
Think out loud, Jess. It's going through your mind.
I'm just thinking where another place I would smoke it. Would I just sit and read? Would I... Is this something to bring to the YR club? Would it... Sporting event. I'm not sure.
This would be a good, no, I'll tell you what, this would be good. This would be a really good cigar for me to be smoking at the tailgate when I'm up at State College. When I'm drinking, when I'm having a glass of wine with it. Probably red.
Oh, definitely red.
Yeah, definitely a red, definitely a real good red wine. It's, in essence, that's what I smoke a lot of the CAOs up there, and so. That's a necessary I'm basically dealing with the tailgates, so when I'm smoking them, just when I'm generally smoking, I'll smoke very light ones up there.
How does this compare to what you generally smoke?
It's about the same strength what I usually smoke, I think.
This is something I can certainly get into. Because I look at the cigar aficionado numbers, but this is certainly a can-do cigar. You know, it almost fits the bill that you could almost smoke it in the morning.
So when you're looking at those numbers, if they posted in there that they gave this, say, an unheard of 75 rating, would you still smoke it?
No, probably not.
If they had an 88 rating on it, would you smoke it?
Probably.
Why? What's the difference?
Does
that rating really make that much of an influence on you?
Sometimes it does.
See, I don't understand that.
See, I have a confession to make.
If I tell you it's a 75, you wouldn't buy it.
Wait a minute, turn the camera off.
I tell you that they kind of gave it an 88.
That's the confession you're going to be making later.
You're right. What's the difference between a Timex and a Rolex? A Timex and Rolex both tell time, but there's more of a cachet.
I don't pay attention to cigar aficionado ratings when I'm looking at cigars.
Either way.
I got to be very honest about it. I know what I'd like.
I'll smoke whether
aficionado says it sucks or it's the greatest cigar in the world.
Whether they
just
like
the way
it.
I am. So
their ratings are
more. And I agree with you 100%, but there's something inside my own makeup
Some
people do. There's something wrong.
I'm not trying to change your opinion.
No, I think, as I said, you're 100% right.
I'm just trying to open you up to a lot more cigars,
right?
Potentially, because
I think what you could
think
you're
focusing
too
much on what somebody else likes.
Which what are you saying? You could do too, instead of looking at the rating right away, take the rating and write it down, or otherwise look at it later. But smoke a cigar first, and then to look at the rating and see what you think, because a lot of those guys are into it for advertising, they're into it for all kinds of other political reasons as far as a rating.
I don't know about aficionado. Do they do that? I mean, I don't know much about the rating system.
I might like something that they don't, and they might
What do you mean, that I don't?
Well, in other words, if Oliva comes out with a new cigar, for instance, and they put it's a cigar aficionado, you know, are they going to be biased because they like Oliva, for instance, or is it just, you know, they're going to be like Consumer Reporter where they say, you know, is it the good, the bad, and the ugly?
But theirs is a blind tasting. They wouldn't know.
They wouldn't know. Okay.
They essentially do the same exact thing that you're doing right now. It's a blind tasting. They get a cigar with no man, they have no idea what it is. But I think they're biased in the ratings, though. I don't know.
That's why I'm asking. I really don't know. That's why I'm asking.
At least from the information they post on their website, it's a totally blind tasting. They handed a cigar just like you just did. I don't agree with a lot of the ratings, though.
Well, it's like anything. It's one person's opinion, too. I mean, that's, you know. And ultimately, at the end of the day, like I said, I don't pay attention. But it's like when people rate wines.
Yeah.
The best bottle of wine I ever had is the one I like.
That's right.
You know, maybe it was $100. Maybe it was 10. Who cares? The point is I like it. And I'd buy it again. You know, I'd buy Yellowtail, for instance. It's a $5, $6, $7 bottle of wine. I drink it all the time. I've had $100 bottles of wine, one of the worst things I ever tasted in my life. So,
besides, it had tail on that label.
True. So, you know.
Yeah, since you put such an emphasis on the CA ratings, would something with a higher number, I don't know, would you be less likely to pick up something with an astronomically high number, thinking that you may not appreciate it? You stick with a certain number range? You only buy 88s, 90s, 91s?
Well, again, even though I've been smoking for a while, I still consider myself new at it, and I use it as a jumping off point. I've smoked some high, you know, what they say high ratings that I didn't like, just like Bud said. But I don't know enough about cigars, the countries that they come from.
I don't either. All you can do is find out if you like some.
Mm-hmm. But then again, someone might like a Dobie Phillies blunt or something.
Oh,
there's it, exactly.
I'm sure there are hobbies.
Sure.
Plenty they sell enough of them, somebody must.
Yeah, nobody must be smoking them.
Yeah.
So I say, usually if I like something, I'll remember what it was, and then I'll look into it after that and find out where it came from, and, you know, things like that. I don't care about the rating, but, you know, Dominican cigar versus Nicaraguan versus African, I mean, there's a whole lot of difference in those things, but it's usually better for me after I smoke one, whether I like it or not, how much it means. And then I'll try to find something else that comes from the same area, maybe the same manufacturer, and see if there's a consistency or if there isn't. You know, and that's the only way you can really educate yourself to what you do like, not necessarily what anybody else does.
That's true. It's true. I mean, everything you're saying is true, but I don't think I'd go after one of his Zenos, a $17 cigar that doesn't have a rating.
You should. Just surprise yourself once in a while. You might really be surprised. That's what I do. I mean, when I was down in Miami, I picked up a $25 cigar thinking, you know, what the hell could this be that's worth $25? You know, but then after I smoked it, it was like, you know what? That was a really good cigar. Because I was really looking at it like, you know, why in the hell is somebody paying $25 for a cigar? It can't be that good. You know, but I was really surprised at the way it was. The way it smoked, the way it finished, I mean, you could lay it down and it stayed burning and burned even and it stayed tasty pretty much all the way through it. So it was like, yeah, there's a good reason for a $25 cigar. Not every day, but, you know, if I got a couple of bucks or had a good day or something specific, and I'm going to go looking for one of those. I hope that I'm not disappointed, because, I mean, you do get one out of a bundle of cigars or out of a run that is going to suck no matter how much you pay for it. I bought a whole bundle at a time, and every cigar was great. And I got the one; it was hard. It wouldn't light right. It didn't draw right. I mean, it just, you know, I ended up getting rid of it. I mean, it happens, but you don't know unless you put the effort into it.
Any cigars that you buy and hold on to for a special occasion?
I can't. I'm a habitual smoker. If I like something and it tastes good, I'll try to. Because like my boys, they just really started to appreciate cigars and they know, you know, they want to smoke a cigar, they're coming to my house. And so whatever I do have usually goes because I can't hold on, so.
Usually the more expensive cigars that I like some more expensive CAOs, like the Sopranos Edition, I'll buy from
Hey,
Doug.
Hey, gentlemen. How goes it?
Dougie.
This is probably one of the most consistent, so far, cigars I've had. Good in the beginning.
Special occasion cigars. You ever buy something really expensive, expecting it to be the best cigar you've ever had, and totally let down by it?
Yeah.
Any cigar in particular?
Cohiba. The real Cohiba. The worst cigar I've ever smoked. Honest to God.
I had a couple of the Ashtons that I usually buy because they're sometimes most consistent, but I've had a couple that I was disappointed with.
My kids gave me a Maximus for Christmas last year. Was it a Crown Maximus, I guess? And it sat in my box for a while, waited for a special occasion to bring it out. Brought it out, I think on Father's Day or something, after it had been in the box for 4 or 5 months. It's like nothing. And I know they spent like $20 for the cigar, but I didn't think it was all that special. I didn't think it was worth it. But Opus X's?
Oh. Yeah, I like those too.
I'll
sit on those for a while.
I got a couple Opus X's in my humidor right now. They're being savored for a special occasion.
Never disappointed by that cigar.
A very good cigar.
And very strong. Very strong.
That's a strong one.
I kind of like the aftertaste so far. It's gone pretty nice.
Yeah.
What do you think of the nicotine strength?
It's not very standard.
It's not really strong. I mean, it's more consistent. It isn't biting you. I'm down to the final third, and it, like the other one, crept up on you on the final third, and it went just and I just thought it was like itching. This one's been pretty consistent throughout, I think.
By the body, the way the smoke feels in the mouth,
it's good.
Pretty tasty. It's got a
very, very, very light, yeah,
light, creamy taste.
Any distinct flavors you're getting out of it?
Kind of like Jesse said.
It seems to be a lot of them, but I can't.
Yeah, there's a bunch of them, but just I can't kind of pin them.
Flowery kind of cocoa taste to it.
I'm not good at getting flavors. Smoke. I either like them or
I can taste them, I just can't pinpoint what they are.
This has a little bit of a... Me a little bit. I just had gum in my mouth, but it was a little bit of a funny aftertaste. It's nice. It's a little bitey at the end or something, the aftertaste.
Would you consider it a complex cigar or is it fairly straightforward?
Yeah, I'd say it's pretty complex.
Yeah, I think it's complex. I mean, I can get a lot of flavors, I just can't pinpoint what they are.
Definitely something that you like. Something makes you think about it. You know, want to smoke another one.
Yeah, it seems like something that you want to sit down and smoke when you know you can enjoy it.
Now, what if you were in the same situation as the first one? You're sitting down to Third and Spruce. Well, you can't have Third and Spruce anymore, but you sit down, light up your cigar. What are you going to order?
Single malt scotch.
This would do well with scotch.
Yeah,
I think so. Drink. Or a real good, nice glass of, you know, red wine or something
white
like
wine.
That.
Something white, something.
Yeah,
white.
I'm not. I can't smoke a white. I mean, I can't smoke a great white wine, but good red wine maybe.
Chardonnay though, a light one.
Yeah.
A real dark.
Yeah, Chardonnay maybe.
Yeah.
There's any particular scotch that would go well with it, or just scotch in general?
Looks like I wanted to get to an F. I got a bottle at home, I can't think of it.
What's it look like?
It comes in a metal can.
Color's a can.
Glenfiddich?
Yeah, Glenfiddich.
Oh yeah, Glenfiddich. Okay.
Yeah, that'd be a good scotch. It it's real, it would definitely accentuate the flavors, because it's got that charcoal flavor to it.
It's scary.
Yeah.
Well, I've had Passport Scotch and some of the lower ends that just to me unpalatable. I don't think anything less than a Doers. It's an all-round Scotch. I think Doers or Giant Walker Red is all right. You can start getting the...
I like the smoothness of the single malt.
Yeah. No Can Do, and
Talking John got me into that Belvane.
Belvane,
which I really
Yeah, he used to bring that up here all the time. That was I've actually had a bottle of that that I finally went through. It took me about 6 months to do it, so it was only drinking on special occasions, but it's very good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you wouldn't want an overly mixed scotch.
That's
with cool. This.
Go good with it.
The cigar malt scotch?
It's a scotch, yeah. My kid just picked it up.
What is it?
It's
Dalmore cigar malt scotch.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And it's not cheap, but it's not as expensive as the other ones. And I was surprised.
It's around about 30.
Yeah, about 30 for
about 30 or 35 bottle. Yeah. Can you pick it up in the States,
right? Yeah.
Okay.
That's where he got it. Because he was, ever since I got him into the finish, he got into, you know, trying other scotch, like I told him. He tried one of those.
What's it called? Malmore?
Cigarmore. It's got a picture of a cigar on the label.
Okay.
It's got a stag.
Yeah.
I might look for that on that. I may actually look for a bottle of that.
It's pretty tasty.
The last time I got it, I couldn't find it over in Wyomissing, but I did in Muhlenberg. Looks like they have a steady supply of it.
I think it goes by the social economy, wherever people are.
So this one, what do you think it's worth to you?
$7 or $8.
Yeah.
You need to think about the way it's burning.
It's even. It's almost like self-correcting in a way.
Mine's self-correcting. Yeah. Didn't touch it up at all. I wanted to see what it would do. And
mine's a little uneven, but it looks like it's catching up. I smoke fast though too, so I don't give a shit a lot of times.
Definitely, I wouldn't mind smoking a cigar either way, in the morning or afternoon, it wouldn't really matter.
You know, the subtle flavors get a little bit more distinctive, but still there's a subtlety in it.
There's always an aftertaste that's not defined. There's always something you're looking at. What the hell is that?
Yeah. You get a little stronger, but still you can't pinpoint each one. It's a nice blend of flavors.
The smoke's very smooth too. It's not real standout.
I like that nice blend of flavors.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is this something you buy on a regular basis?
Definitely.
Yeah, absolutely. This one I would.
Yeah, I would.
Absolutely.
Yeah, what was the other one?
There was really no taste on it until the end. Then it started kicking in.
But the kick was like an afterburner.
Yeah.
I mean, once it kicked in, boy, it was there.
Yeah.
It just was not subtle. It just boom.
Huh. Yeah, but even though this one's getting better, getting stronger, it's not changing to the point that, you know, it's going to make you say, I'm not too sure about it. Definitely something that's pleasing.
I don't know if it's because I'm drinking the Pepsi with it.
But it's like I said when we started, I figured it was
like
the taste
better.
Same.
I was drinking Coke with it, actually. I like the taste a little better, I think.
How does it stack up to what you normally buy?
It's something I would usually smoke anyway.
This is something I usually smoke, so it's definitely consistent along those lines.
I'm not sure. I think it stands out as an enjoyable smoke, and if I was looking to become a one, you know, not a one cigar guy, but something that I would mainly smoke, I think I would look to this. But then again, why just constrict yourself to one smoke and not enjoy everything else there, regardless of the number.
I definitely, definitely give it to a friend. Definitely recommend it.
Mm-hmm.
If you were to hand this to a new cigar smoker or a seasoned cigar smoker, or whatever you want to look at it, what qualities in the cigar could you tell them they could expect?
I would tell them that, from what I figured, from what I've smoked from it, in the beginning there were three distinct flavors. I felt, I said it was woody, sweet, and nutty. All of a sudden, it became more cocoa to me, but you could still not taste, but you could infer, maybe that's a better word, a complexity. So in the beginning, there were, for me, there were three distinct tastes, but now it's more of a complex blend of flavors, and each one is very good. But Bud said there wasn't just one specific that hits you in the beginning or hits you at the end.
Yeah, I'd have to tell them it's a pretty complex smoke. There's a lot of flavors in there.
Just tell them take their time and enjoy it.
Yeah.
Just get something. Get something to drink, sit down, light it up. Be prepared.
Now, what are you looking for in a cigar? Do you want it to have lots of complexity up front, or do you want it to start out slow and just work to it?
I like a cigar that's got a lot of flavors in it.
Something
I don't like something one-dimensional that's the same from beginning to end. I like it to change. I like a lot of flavors.
I have to agree with you on that.
I agree, too. But I also like to be consistent. I like to have the flavor throughout.
Something to surprise you on the end.
Yeah.
I want to finish
I'm not,
it just
I'm not
like
a big
started.
Believer. Hey, I don't like, you know, get down to the end where all of a sudden it hits you. It just doesn't.
I don't know. I like a cigar that has surprises in it.
That's what I was saying.
It kind of just hits you with a different flavor every now and again. You know. I just enjoy that. Of course, something as long as they're all pleasant flavors.
Sure. No, you don't want to do. I don't mind it being and true. I don't mind it being strong, just as long as it's consistent. You know.
Finish my website. Take away all brand loyalty.
But if I want to buy a mild cigar,
oh yeah,
I don't want to get.
No. I agree. Yeah. Yeah. Do you think this is strong?
No.
I think it's like a medium body.
Yeah. I agree with you. You know, if I pick up a mild cigar. I want it to stay mild the whole way through, but I don't mind the flavor somewhat changing as I progress through the cigar.
The flavor, right, but
as long as you know it stays a mild cigar,
exactly.
Or a medium cigar, whatever.
Exactly. Like that now, first one.
Now there are times that you know there are certain cigars I know that the flavor is going to build as I go down, and you know there are times when. That's okay, because that's what I'm looking for. But for the most part, I want something that's going to flavor profile, so to speak, the strength that's going to stay the same.
It was good.
But the flavors
yeah,
themselves.
I got to get doing myself. I got to open a bunch of the Irish.
Thank you much. See you again.
See you, Brian.
See you later.
Thank you, my friend.
Appreciate it.
Thanks for sitting
with
us.
Absolutely.
Room, okay.
Yep.
See you again, man.
Thanks.
If you ever get one of those kind of like a monotone cigar, it tastes the same the whole way through.
Mm-hmm.
They get boring after a while.
Yeah, you're right.
Sounds like some girls I know.
Yeah, that's true.
We've been in for about 50 minutes. What do you think of the burn rate?
I thought the burn rate was going to be a lot faster than it is. From the appearance of the cigar, I thought it was going to be a real quick burn, but it's not. had a real light draw. That was another reason I thought it was going to go fast, but it's not.
About ready to know what they are?
Yeah, I am.
What you smoked was a boutique cigar made in Santiago, Dominican Republic by the same guys that make La Tradición Cubana. It's Bacalera LTC. Both of them run about $5.75 apiece. First one had an Ecuadorian grown Connecticut shade wrapper. I don't know what the binder was. Originally it was Honduran, but since the reblend, it really could be anything. The filler is Dominican. And as I mentioned, made in Santiago, Dominican Republic. Second cigar has a Brazilian apricotta wrapper on it, Maduro leaf. Same thing with the binder, I'm not sure what it is. Filler is Dominican, again, $5.75, made by the same company. The company is Jameson Cigar Company. There is no correlation between Jameson Irish whiskey and Jameson cigars.
Is this a new brand? A new cigar manufacturer, Jameson?
A couple of months, I guess they've been out. Because I had the original and didn't really care for it. I think the new ones are much better than they were.
I had the original, too. I had to agree with them. I had the original Connecticut.
Somebody, I think if you're going to give it to someone that smokes,
I'd be a little hesitant.
You're going to have to say,
just because
just smoke
looked.
It,
yeah.
And don't look at it. You know? If you get it, someone doesn't smoke that much, and that kind of makes a difference.
How long
were
we smoking this?
About an hour.
Oh, but.
Yeah, that
wasn't bad. I like the second one.
Is this a Corona or a
Robusto? 5x50.